folks. Welcome to tonight's game. This one's going to be good between the Norfolk State Spartans and the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. Number 15 is the key guy on this team. He's definitely someone we're going to watch out for tonight.
This kid is great on the defensive end of the floor, Brad, but on the offensive end, he's virtually unstoppable.
The Scarlet Knights will definitely try and capitalize on his capabilities tonight, Dick. The Scarlet Knights are in for what should be an easy one tonight, Dick, but how do they stay interested enough to win this game?
Interested enough, Brad. They still have to do the following things. Number one, get the ball on the interior. See if you can get that big man into foul trouble. Second, if you win the glass, baby, and you'll own the boards, you'll win the game. Lastly, be aggressive defensively and force the offense out of its rhythm.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court and let's get the action underway. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Nixon receives the pass. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
He takes a three. Not a wise decision to take that shot there.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. He looks for the bomb. Off the rim and no good. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
He keeps his dribble as they reset. Down inside. Entry pass in the paint. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Ball loose, but the offense got it back. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
They're working around the perimeter. Gave it up. Way out on top. Controlling the ball.
Great play to take that to the basket.
The student body looks to be full with rage and willing to cheer on the old home team.
They look like they're having a blast.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting posts.
Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Can't get the shot to go. Number 15, pump fakes. Goes up for two. Doesn't go. The Scarlet Knights will have their fans going silly if they can get a stop here. Ura handles the pass. Way off target. If they can get a basket here, Dick, this crowd will erupt. They go into the low block. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a defensive post player.
Let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Guys, he seemed very focused from the beginning. His game face was on, and he understands it's his time to perform. Let's send it back to you.
All right, thanks, Aaron. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works. Try to go inside.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
They work the perimeter. He gets the rejection. The ball goes out of play. Oh, and look at the crowd and look at the reaction.
I think the home fans are going crazy. There's jubilation.
High post flashes for the opportunity. They work it around the arc. Tries for two.
He used the screen beautifully to free himself for the easy deuce.
dribble, gives it up. Outside jumper.
They're having a rough time getting it on the drop, Brad. They should take it to the basket and get some easy hoops.
For the bucket. Can't get the shot to drop. Dick, he really seems to be getting great position down there in the low block.
Yeah, he really is gaining position because he gets the good angle, and they also have the good entry from the wing.
And, Dick, look at this sellout crowd, and they are loving it.
Oh, they're ecstatic, baby. They're ecstatic. Great team play.
The center handles the feed. For two, makes the shot. He draws a foul. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
He's got the post flashing if he wants it. He tries to knock down the three. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
He's doing it all right now for this team. It'll be interesting to see if he can keep this up.
Keys receives the ball. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
Off the rim and no good. At the end of the first half, the Scarlet Knights are ahead by five. Kent State. Looks like they're shooting blanks from the floor, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing. They're missing tons of field goal opportunities. And it's shocking for this ball club. It's time for them to go back to the drawing boards and talk things over.
Dick, as a coach, heading into the second half, focus player update, and you know what it takes. What is it going to take for this young man?
Well, I think they got to get him the ball right away and have him attack the basket. I think he's got to be able to become much more aggressive on the offensive side.
Now trying to feed the low block. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot. I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle, too, when he goes up and under. He seals off the defensive player.
Now they'll bring it up. Working it around the perimeter. Turns it over.
Another turnover created by great D, Brad.
Down low, there's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step, very slow.
Goes up for two. They still don't score. Perimeter. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter.
Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
To feed the low block. There they come with a double team to stop it. And the ball goes out of play. Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, do you think?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you've got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
He shoots from outside. He drains the shot. Tries for two, and he missed. Intercepted. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews and score for us, Aaron.
Brad and Dick, the coaching staff told me before the game, this is the one guy they need to get going quickly and early. They said when he gets hot, his entire team will follow suit, and they'll feel good about having the game in hand.
Thanks, Aaron. See who's got more coming out of this timeout as play resumes. That brings the lead to 8 points, Dick.
But 8 points doesn't secure a win at this point, Brad.
He shoots from the top of the key. This guy's not looking for anybody else out there.
You're right, Brad. He's got a little too...
He rejects it.
That has to be intimidating, Brad.
He gets the board. And he's going to pick up the foul and all. Look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
What I call a hard screen. The ball goes out of bounds. Gave it up. On the dribble, gives it up. Cross court. Look at these fans. They're loving it.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby.
Foul charge. Oh, and you talk about a happy group of fans. Listen to this crowd.
Oh, there's all kinds of people standing and cheering and going wacky. Up and inside.
Well, Dick, it looks like they're going to spend a little bit of time fouling right here.
They have to foul in order to stop the clock, Brad.
And the clock stopped with a foul. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Nobody likes this part of the game, but the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. And the clock stopped with a foul. He goes to the free throw line. Misses the front end of the one and one. They might try and surprise the opposition with a little change here, Dick.
That might not be a bad idea. The lead is up to eight.
They could be starting to pull away here, Dick. He shoots from the top of the key. Off the rim and no good. And yet another foul. He'll visit the charity stripe. Makes the foul shot. Second shot. Well, the lead is 10, Dick. Are you starting to hear the fat lady?
Well, Brad, she could be warming up right now.
Kicks it out. Had an open guy in the post and went the other way. Goes for the deep one. I don't think that's the guy they want shooting that shot.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Dumps it in. Picked off. The point guard gets the ball. He launches a three. That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shots.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
We're going to move it around the perimeter. Our focus player update, our final one of the ball game, and he led his team to victory.
I tell you one thing, he was sensational. He made all big shots. He really wanted the ball. I thought he was very aggressive offensively.
Rutgers found themselves in a heck of a battle before pulling away at the end.
They expected to be the victor. They just didn't expect it to be this close.
Brad Nestler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.